We're back on Cougar Paws here today on KVGB. Jeremy Combs, basketball coach at Barton Community College, joining us here on the program today. 12th coach in Barton's 53-year history. Jeremy, congratulations. I guess when you found out you got the job, I guess the initial thoughts you had on taking over the program here in Great Bend.
Well, it's an unbelievable feeling. I mean, obviously, you know, like Trevor said earlier, this is big time basketball. This is a big time program. This is like KU, Duke, when you're talking junior college basketball. So was really excited. This is what you work for your whole life. You know, my 23 years of coaching, this is where I wanted to get to. So obviously when we found out this is where we were coming, we were fired up.
Chanute's a nice town. It really is. And when you're there for 14 years and you raise your family there, that's always other things that you have to take into consideration when you take a job like this.
Well, and there's no question. There were other jobs, obviously, that came around that we passed up on over the years to keep our family there and just decided not to. But this was just an opportunity that you can't pass. And so, when I talked to my family about it, they gave me the blessing and said, let's go do this. So we're super excited. And like I said, we love Chanute. We'll always have a place there. It'll always be home. But we're going to make Great Bend our new home.
We've kind of seen teams kind of go one way or the other right now. Neosho going to Division II, which I think is a great move for them. We're going to have the schools that, you know, have more resources to put for this. And that was that a thought for you to maybe move to Barton?
Yeah.
I mean, there's a lot of jobs open out there.
Yeah, there's no question. I mean, you know, they probably should have gone Division II a long time ago, mm-hmm. to be honest. And I kind of was the reason why they didn't. And I fought that for a long, long time. But things just over the years continue to get harder and harder and harder as they gave more money to other schools, allowing them to do fulls and things like that. Whereas, we just couldn't do that, yeah. You know? So we had basically seven books and tuition and fees, scholarships, and that was it. And that's what we were working with. So, the rest of the kids would be walk-ons or whatever we needed. So they needed to do that. They needed to make that move. Over the last 4 years, you know, just it really took a toll on me as far as trying to compete with everybody else. So when that came up that they asked if we wanted to go Division II, I said, yeah, that's probably the best option. And at that point, you know, I would have with open arms, taken that task on. I think, you know, obviously being able to pick 17 of your games would be much easier. You'd win some more ball games. And then again, compete with some of the teams over there that have the same kind of budgets. Neosho still, even at Division II, doesn't have, I think they're second to last in Division II with scholarships, you know, so they're still behind the eight ball a little bit, but it closes the door, closes the gap a little bit more. And they'll be a little bit more competitive. So the next person should be able to get in there and win some games and make it look a lot better than we had in the last few years.
That said, how good did it feel to win a region championship in 2016?
Oh, every time we beat, you know, a Hutch or we knocked off a Coffeyville or whoever it was, Paris, Texas, whoever we beat that was nationally ranked. I mean, that was unbelievable. But to be able to do that and put that together, people always said you couldn't win there. And so for us to do that, we put together a really nice squad, really, really talented kids that we developed over the years. And so to be able to do that was just phenomenal.
You look back at that team and its makeup, is that obviously you got it right there. Is that kind of the Jeremy Combs philosophy on piecing together a basketball team, what you're able to do there? Obviously you need talent, right?
Yeah, there's no question. And you know, some of those guys, I mean, we had some guys that were extremely talented. Freddie McSwain, who ended up going to Indiana, but you know, coming out of high school, he only had two schools that even recruited him. So it was us and a school out of Georgia, and then Freddie developed into a player. And I think that's what we really pride ourselves on over there, was taking kids that were good but turning them into really good basketball players and with its player development. Also with our strength and conditioning and things like that. And so we just had a group of kids that really wanted to get better. And so I think now, not just having that work ethic, but we're also going to put now we're going to put together talented kids, really super talented kids that can come in right now, and we're going to make them even better here. So we're just on another level here at Barton.
Obviously, you had some chemistry on that team, though, too.
Yeah, no question. The chemistry's huge, but we did have some chemistry. And I always show guys photos of that team, you know, guys hugging each other after every game, and the locker rooms were amazing, you know. So you definitely have to have that chemistry. There's no question.
I'd always say Craig Fletcher, all hats off to him to be able to coach at the junior college ranks for as long as he did, because it is a different world. While you're trying to get kids in there, get them better to win games, there's always they're looking at, okay, where am I going to go after this? And that's a hard thing to balance sometimes as a coach, and you see teams fall apart because of it many times.
Yeah, there's no question. And you look at teams that, you know, they have that one kid that scores 32 a game, and they're not that great, or they don't win the championship. But you see the teams like I had that went to the national tournament, and guys, you know, Freddie, I think he averaged like 15 points a game, you know, and so we had a bunch of guys in double-digit scoring. So it was a complete team, and that's why they won.
You haven't been on the job very long, but you said recruiting's gone pretty well. In fact, you're getting close to getting your roster to where it's going to be for what will roll out next November.
Yeah, absolutely. We dove into it. You know, again, I wasn't able to use all the resources and connections that I had over at Neosho. You know, I've got plenty of guys that want to send me players, and you know, they'd say, "Hey, what kind of scholarships you have?" And yeah. So, okay, well, this is the type of player I can send you.
So you call some of those guys back and say, yeah. "Well, listen."
Yeah. So now, when they find out what I have here, they, okay, hey, I've got a different kind of player for you. You know, so some of the Australian kids that we've signed, you know, some of my buddies have said, "Hey, we'll send you a pro, a guy that can that will play at the professional level one day in Australia." So some of those guys that we're getting are going to be some big time players.
So we have some Aussies coming in.
Oh, we got them from everywhere. We got some. We got two from Russia. We got two from three from Australia, and then we got six Kansas kids. I love my Kansas kids. Just I throw that out there right now. I love my. I'm a Kansas guy, so I'm going to bring Kansas kids in too, and I've got some really good ones. Cougar Downing is going to come over from Neosho with and play for me. DeAndre Hughes is also going to come over and play with me. So those are two really good, talented players that that'll make an impact here right away.
Is this Cougar Downing the second?
No.
Okay. It's
well, not. Actually, it would be his uncle is Cougar.
Okay. All right.
Yes.
Well, and that takes
he played. I believe he played at Dodge City.
Okay.
If I'm not mistaken.
I mean, he played at Atchison High School, so that shows you how old I am, because I go back and Pratt played them in the state championship. Anyway, so you've got a lot. That's got to be nice, because when you come in and you take this job, say, man, I'm getting started late here. How am I even going to put it? And boom, you get it done. That's got to make you feel pretty good.
No, it does. And, you know, I'm excited to continue the recruiting, you know, over the next, you know, year as we continue to play and then start figuring out what we need and things like that. You know, we had some opportunities at some Division I transfer guys, but I went out and got a couple guys that are qualifiers, you know, that maybe because of this COVID stuff, you know, we probably wouldn't have had a chance at, but, you know, there's not enough scholarships out there right now, and it's kind of backlogged. And so we were able to kind of steal some of those guys. So hopefully we'll get them out in a year and then kind of get the ball rolling with some new freshmen coming in.
So describe a Jeremy Combs basketball team.
Well, it'll be different from what you've seen. I mean, we will definitely play differently. We do play fast. We, you know, we'll mix things up defensively. We will shoot a lot of threes. We'll play inside out. You know, we're going to have some size. This is going to be a huge team. I mean, we've got some big guys. The two Australians are big. I've got one of the other Australians is 6'6", and he's a wing. We signed another 6'6" wing from Louisiana. I mean, so we're not just going to be big inside. We're going to be big everywhere. So you'll see us mix up our defenses and throw some zones, and maybe the next time down we'll be playing man, and you know, just keep teams on their toes. And then offensively, you'll see a team that plays as a team. I mean, we're going to work the basketball a little bit. I mean, we're not going to slow it down by any stretch, but we're going to take great shots and score the ball at a high percentage.
How do you develop contacts to get players from Russia and Australia?
That's 32 years of coaching.
Okay.
And I think, you know, the biggest part of that too is when you take care of these kids when they come to you, and you develop them and make them into players, and then you move them on. You know, that speaks volumes to those guys. And so you make that good connection, and they know when they're getting players to you that they're going to be taken care of.
Jeremy Combs with this new basketball coach at Barton Community College. So what have you been found? What is Barton's reputation out there across the country in junior college basketball, Jeremy?
Well, like I said, this is like the Duke. You know, this is Duke KU of basketball, you know, and as soon as I say that name Barton, they know who we are, you know. So that's one thing that's always been amazing. I think we did a great job of getting Neosho out there. You know, when I first started, they had no clue who that was. And then they'd see me out, they'd see our logo out, because I was out all the time recruiting and doing things. But, you know, this is one that's already established. This is not, you know, this isn't like going into Neosho and rebuilding anything. There's no rebuild here. This is just taking the foundation that Coach put together here, Coach Fletch put together, all the coaches from the past, Jerry Mullins, all those guys, all those guys. And so, you know, we will continue that. And I can tell you right now, every day when I think about those guys, when Jerry Mullins, when he texts me about players or this, that, or whatever, I'm thinking about him and knowing I've got to represent. So we'll bring it every single day and make sure that we're putting a good product on the floor.
Jeremy, you've got the podium right now. What do you want to tell Cougar fans right now?
Well, hopefully we can get, well, actually with this COVID deal, there wasn't very many fans.
Yeah.
I want to get that place packed. I've seen photos of that place, you know, where they're standing around the sides. I remember when Trevor and I were I'll never forget. It was Trevor and I, we were over at Pratt and we played Hutch and we played Barton over there. And I mean, people were standing around the Beaver Dome. And that's where I want to get it. I want to get people back out to the games. And I think it'll happen. I mean, I think one thing is it's going to help us is I think people will be hungry to get out because they've been stuck in their houses for so long.
All right. Welcome back. We'll have Jeremy Combs on. We can talk more Cougar basketball on Sports Day, but this is, I'd like to get to know. So you're originally from Topeka, right?
Yep.
Okay. All right. Hayden Wildcat.
Yeah.
You played for a pretty good coach there, right?
Yep. Ben Eske.
Yeah. Okay. So you also attended, we had a good friend who coached baseball at Nicholls State down in Thibodaux, Louisiana. What was that like? You went down there for spent a little bit of time and then went back and coached. Is that right?
Yeah. Yeah. I think my favorite story is ordering food for the first time down there and they couldn't understand me. They thought I had an accent, but I couldn't understand them. So it's been interesting. But then also, you know, when we'd stop the bus on the side of the road and get some, you know, players would get off and they'd get boudin or whatever it was on the side of the road. And I'm like, all right, I'm not eating anything from the side of the road, but they absolutely loved it.
Well, they have to get you and Lyles Lashley together because, you know, he's maybe are you a Cajun cook at all? Because Lyles is kind of taking this on like he's the ultimate Cajun chef here in Great Bend.
I'm not much of a cook at all.
Okay.
when my wife's not cooking, it's like PB&Js for me and the boys.
Okay, your wife is originally from Pretty Prairie, right?
Yeah.
And met her at Kansas Wesleyan.
Yep.
She comes from a Crable name. That's very well known, right?
Yeah, I married well.
Okay. So as we head in, and tell me about your assistant coach.
Jamie Baddish. He played for me. You know, I'm kind of to the point in my career as a coach where my assistants have been players for me. You know, I like that because one, they know what I do, you know, and that type of thing. But, you know, just being able to get my own players that want to get into this profession and get them going was always kind of a goal of mine. You know, not just moving on my players, but moving on my coaches.
Okay. Now, you said in-state is, you like your in-state players. That's something, and a lot of times they're not getting recruited as much.
You know, a few years ago when they took the limitations off the conference, you know, it was kind of, you know, it used to be when we'd go to games, there'd be 15 coaches there recruiting one kid, you know, and so, but and then it kind of got to the point where it'd just be me. You know, and or a couple other guys kind of trickling in, but so I've kind of took that on. You know, obviously being a Kansas kid, I love my Kansas guys, and so we've always got them. In fact, I think last year we started 3 or 4 Kansas kids, so we're going to continue to do that. I mean, like I said, we're going to get some big time international kids, some big time out of state guys, but we're also going to get all the best, you know, Kansas kids we can.
Yeah, Jake Stoppel from Ellsworth was a good player, went on to play at Fort Hays State. So talk about your in-state recruiting class that you have coming in this year.
Yeah, so we have we've got some really good ones. Obviously I went after and I, you know, he grew up with my kids and things like that a little bit. But we signed Trey Rolfs, not just the other day. We also got the Thompson kid from Hutch, you know, so he's going to be a really, really good one. Miles Thompson, about a 6'6", 6'7" kid that can really shoot it. You know, so we've got some really good ones coming in that like I said, will come in and play right away and mesh well with those other guys.
Jeremy, it's great to meet you. Good luck. I was going to say, gosh, you need to get back out here and get your team put together. Life is all good right now. Oh, and real quick, your kids are going to?
Great Bend
High. Okay. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
You know how talk goes, you know.
Yeah, absolutely.
All these coaches reaching in. Hey, you want to come over? We've got some nice housing opportunities over here in this community.
Yeah.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Great meeting you again. That's Jeremy Combs, new basketball coach at Barton Community College here on Cougar Paws. Stay tuned. News coming up next.